Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and safe at home. Welcome to online classes. This side Khushbu Rizwani from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota. Students, today I am here to teach you computer and today we are going to study chapter number 6. So, take out your books and open page number 5151. Children, the name of the chapter is Introduction to WordPad. In the previous chapter, we studied about introduction to paint, where we studied how to paint, how to draw pictures using paint. And in this chapter, we are going to see how to type text using WordPad. So let's start. You use a program called paint to color a picture. As I told you, we use program paint to color a picture we learned in the previous chapter. Similarly, to write letters, stories and poems on a computer, you use a program called WordPad. Children, like to draw pictures, we use paint. Similarly, to write anything on a computer, we use program called as WordPad. WordPad is a program used to write text on a computer. What is WordPad, children? WordPad is a program used to write text on a computer. We can write stories, we can write poems, we can write paragraphs, anything which we want to write on computer, we use which program, children? We use WordPad. Let us know more about WordPad. Now, how to open WordPad? Now, children, we will see how to open this program, how to open WordPad. For that, some steps are given over here and we have to follow these steps. Let's see step number 1. Click start button. The start menu appears. You can see over here, this is an icon called start button. What we will do, we will first on step number 1, we will click start button. What will appear? The start menu will appear. Step 2. Click all programs, a sub-menu appears. After start, we will click to all programs. This menu will appear and from this menu, what will appear? All programs. We will click to all programs. This sub-menu will appear. This is sub-menu. Step 3, click on accessories. Now from sub-menu, we will click to accessories. This is sub-menu. And from all these programs which we will click to accessories. This is step number 3. Step 4. Click on WordPad. The WordPad window appears. Now in accessories, this when we will click on accessories, children, this menu will appear. And from all the program, what we will click WordPad. So after clicking on WordPad, what will appear on the screen? WordPad program will appear on the screen. So what are these? All these are the steps to open WordPad. Now do you know? Notepad is also a program used to write text on a computer. It has less features than WordPad. Children, like WordPad, there is one more program known as Notepad. It is also used to write text on computer. But Notepad has less features than WordPad. Now let's move further. Now we will after studying how to open WordPad, now we will see what are the different parts of WordPad window. Children, this is WordPad. Now here we have different parts. Let us see. We have quick access toolbar, we have ribbon, we have WordPad button, we have cursor, and we have text area. These are the different parts of WordPad window. Let us learn about these parts now. Ribbon. First, we will study about ribbon. This is ribbon. Children, you can see over here. This is called ribbon. The ribbon contains two parts. Now children, ribbon also has its parts. Ribbon, it contains two parts. How many parts? Two parts. Tabs and groups. Now ribbon has two parts known as tabs and group. Now home and view. These are the tabs. And below these where we have font, paragraph, insert things. These are called groups. So ribbon has two parts, that is tabs and groups. Each tab contains commands arranged in different groups. Now, as I told you, each tab has commands that contains different groups. Like font, we have different font over here, we have different sizes. Then paragraph, we have how to edit the paragraph, how to write the text in the center, in corner, at the last. Different commands arranged in different groups. I hope this ribbon is clear to you. Ribbon has two parts, that is tabs and groups. After ribbon, we will study about quick access toolbar. Now, this is quick access toolbar, children. It is present above the ribbon. It helps to do common tasks with just one click. Now, children, this icon is present above the ribbon and it helps us to do any task, to perform any task with just one click. Like if you want to save any file, so once if we will click over here, it will be saved. If you want to move back to some previous page, or if you have done, if you want to move back, once we will click this and we will be on the next, on the previous page. If you want to move to the next page, then we will click this. So by single click, we can use these icons. And where are these icons present? These icons are present in quick access toolbar. And where is quick access toolbar present? It is present above the ribbon. WordPad button. It is present just below the quick access toolbar. Now, where is WordPad button present? It is present just below the quick access toolbar. Below this, this button is present. On clicking this button, a menu appears. When we click this button, then menu appears in which we have new, open, save, save as, all the names of different file. If you want to open a new file, then we click to new. If you want to open an already existing file, then we click on open. If you want to save the file, then we click on save. By clicking on this, different menu appears. This menu contains different options which help us to work in WordPad. As I explained you just now, this contains different options such as new, open, save, save as, and many more. Next is text area. It is a large white space to type text. Now, text area is that white blank area, and what we do in this text area, we type the text. In the given blank space, in the given white area, we type our text, and this area is called text area. Next is cursor. It is a small blinking line on the text area. You can see a blinking line over here. From where I have written my name and the place where I stop, the cursor will blink over there. And if again I will start from there, the cursor will move from the place where it has already stopped. So it is a small blinking line appear on the text area. It is a small blinking line appear that appears on the text area. The cursor tells the position of the typed text. As I told you just now, if I will write any word, if I will stop there, the cursor will be stopped over there. And if again I will write the word, then it will be typed from the place where I stopped. So it will show the position of the typed text. Now let's move further. Now we will see how to do typing. Typing text. You can enter text in WordPad by simply using the keys of the keyboard. Children, in paint program, how we used to draw pictures? Using the mouse. But in WordPad, we want to write the text, we want to type the text. So by which part of the computer we type the text? We type the text with the help of keyboard, because keyboard has small buttons on it, keyboard has alphabets, numbers. So with the help of keys on the keyboard, present on the keyboard, we type our text. For example, alphabet and number keys to type, backspace key to delete, and space bar key to give spaces. Just now, as I told you, different keys, we have different keys on keyboard. This is our keyboard, and we have different keys on keyboard, such as alphabet keys, number keys. Alphabet keys to type alphabet, they are marked from A to Z. Number keys, they are marked from 0 to 9. Backspace key, if you want to erase the data. Delete key, if you want to delete it. Space bar key, if you want to give space between our text. So these are the different keys on the keyboard. Now, do you know the shape of the mouse pointer changes from this, from arrow to this on the text area? Now, children, the cursor which is present like this. Whenever we use our mouse for clicking something or for clicking any icon or to open any folder, the cursor is like this. But if we write any text on WordPad, if we write our text or type any text on WordPad, then the cursor is like this on the text area. Now, how to save your work? Now, children, after learning how to open window, how to type text, what are the different parts of WordPad, now we will see how to save our work. You can save your work in the computer as a file so that you can use it whenever you want. Now, children, if we have completed our work and if you want to save our work, yes, we can save our work so that in case we want to see that work again, we can open our already existing file. But for that, we have to follow some steps. Now, what are the steps? Let's see. To save a WordPad file, follow the given steps. As I told you, there are some steps we need to follow. Let us study steps. Step 1. Click WordPad button, a menu appears. Now, I explain you WordPad button. This is WordPad button. It is below quick access toolbar. As I explained you earlier, WordPad button is just below quick access toolbar. You can see this is quick access toolbar and below it is WordPad button. What we will do? We will click for one step number 1. We will click WordPad button. What will appear? A menu appears. This menu will appear on the screen. Step 2. Click save option. Now what we will do? We will click save option because we have to save our file. So what we will do? We will click save option. Now what will happen? A new window appears. When we will click this save option, this new window will appear. Now step 3. In the file name box, type the name for your work. Now when this window will appear, we will write the name of the file which we want to give. If I want to save the file by my name, so I will write my name in place of file name. Okay, so in step number 3, what we have to do? In the file name box, we have to type the name of the file, how we want to save, by which name we want to save the file. Step 4, click save button. After writing name over here, what we will do? We will click save button. And after clicking save button, our file will be saved in the WordPad window. Now, after saving the file, now we will learn how to open our saved file. To open a file you have already saved, follow the given steps. To open our saved file, again we have to follow some steps to open an already existing file. Step 1. Click WordPad button, a menu appears. Again, in step number 1, what we will do? We will click this WordPad button and this menu will appear. Step 2. Click the open option, a new window appears. Now we will click this open option and this window will appear. And आप when this window will appear. Step 3, click the file you want to open. The file gets selected. Now children, you can see in this new window we have different file names. In this new window we have different file names. So here we have to select the name of the file which we want to open. Step 4, click open button. After selecting our file, if you want to open any file, like I want to open this file named as school. If you want to open this file, so what I will do? I will select this. And after selecting this, I will click open button. And after clicking this open button, our already saved file will be opened. Now next is, we will learn how to close WordPad. After learning how to save, how to open an already saved file, now we will see how to close WordPad. After completing your work, close the WordPad program. Children, after completing our work, what we do? We have to close our program. So, to close the WordPad program, follow the given. To close our WordPad program, we have to follow some steps again. Step 1, click WordPad button. What we will do? We will click this WordPad button. Step 2, click exit option. And at below of these, when this menu will appear, in the end, in the below, this icon is there, that is called exit. So what we will do? We will click exit option. Then we will be out from the WordPad window. Now children, I hope you have understood this chapter. Keep learning, keep studying. Thank you.